of wireless nature. And then there's so much flowers around, plants that you can even breathe in or see, a lot of beautiful scenery. Imagine a Ghana like that. Now, apart from its beautifying our environment, it also promotes the ecosystem. You know, we are promoting horticulture and floriculture here as well. And that is what the Ghana Garden and Flower Show has sought and has been doing for the last 9 years. The 9th edition is here, and that's what we're going to be talking about this morning. And it's been championed, or has always been championed, by Stratcom Africa. So this morning, Stratcom Africa's very own Esther Koba is here to talk about this initiative that she started some 9 years ago. She got some sponsors on board. One that she's really impressed about this morning, that she's saying, listen, allow me to talk about them because they have been mind-blowing. So I'm going to allow her to do all that she wants to do. But good morning. Good to see you.
Good morning. It's so great to be here.
That's a strikingly beautiful jacket.
Oh, my goodness.
Representing the motherland. This is so beautifully put together.
Thank
when I saw you,
you,
I just had to say it. And I'm saying it again on air.
Thank you. It's
maybe I will be blessed.
It's a cuddling design.
It's so beautiful.
Yes, thank
very,
you. When
very
I'm coming
beautiful.
To talk to beautiful Cookie, I don't know how you do it. Wake up so early in the morning and look so refreshing every day, like the flowers that I love.
I know. I know. It can only be grace. Yes. I'm very grateful that you're here this morning as well. So let's talk horticulture. Let's talk flowers. Let's talk greenery. Let's talk gardens. When I was told about this interview, okay, so Strategic Communication Africa, Esther Koba, I said, okay, this is a 360 communications company. Flowers, horticulture, where is the correlation? How where did this come from? Because most people will say, oh, my mother used to have a garden. We used to water flowers in the morning, or maybe my granddad or grandmother. So that's where they will normally pick their inspiration from. Where did yours come from?
For communication is central to development.
Okay.
So for a developing nation like Ghana, if you're a communications professional, mm-hmm. you have no choice but to use that profession to advance the development of the country, including helping corporates to enhance their profitability and individuals to improve their livelihoods. And that is at the center of what Stratcom Africa has been doing since, you know, for the past 9 years. We are communicating the environmental, commercial, aesthetic and health benefits of floriculture. And it is through our behaviors that we can achieve this. And there is a big role for communication in behavior development and behavior change. Mm-hmm. So over the past 9 years, what we have been doing is using communication as a tool to build a positive behaviors towards floriculture. And by so doing, also helping Ghana to realize the UN Sustainable Development Goals. Thankfully, my mother taught me to farm.
So that's where it came from.
And also, I went to a school called Mofretro Children's Garden. We turned 90 years last year, where each dormitory had a garden. And so I developed with that orientation to the extent that at some point, living in Accra with my auntie and my auntie in Airport Residential Area, I had a 55-bed onion garden.
You did?
And I used to harvest this and go around the homes in that
to sell them.
To sell them. And that's how I bought my shoes. When I did national service at Presec, I hardly bought anything from the market.
You grew everything.
I grew everything.
Yourself.
So in my front yard, you see a garden, a beautiful flower garden. I cannot understand how anyone can exist without green and beautiful flowers around them. And if we did that, we would be protecting our environment and saving people from dying during the rainy season. Because every time we're running to government, we're saying government should come and do this about the environment. each of us has a responsibility to clean our own front yard and our backyard and use it to benefit us and not throw litter and garbage around which fill the gutters, block them. Then when people die, we think the floods killed them.
Yeah.
It's our litter that blocked them. The gutters and contributed to the floods.
Right. You're so right. Now, so coming from this premise, you must have been very excited this year on the 11th of June when the Green Ghana project was launched. And okay, so the project is supposed to grow or was supposed to plant at least 5 million trees in the country. Let me just pick your mind a little bit on it. Do you think 5 million trees was overambitious? Is this something that we could attain?
We have to attain that and more.
Okay.
If we are not going to get over ambitious about planting trees, then we have to get over anxious about each of us dying or coming up, getting all kinds of diseases. It's not over ambitious.
Okay.
And it shouldn't even come from government.
Right.
It should come from every one of
us.
Right. It is our individual responsibility, not the responsibility
to
of
green,
government.
To green Ghana.
So if government has said it,
right.
we should take it up and do it.
You know, following up on the progress of this Green Ghana project, Samuel Jinapor, the Minister of Lands and Natural Resources, actually stated a while back that we had even exceeded our target and that... the target was 5 million trees, but when he checked, I think some 2 months, a month or so ago, we had actually planted 7 million trees in the country. I thought that was really laudable. But moving forward, as a gardener yourself, how do you think we'll be able to sustain and maintain all these trees that we have planted?
We have to educate people. First of all, it shouldn't be a project. It should be a lifestyle.
Right.
And that is what Stratcom Africa, leading the Ghana Garden and Flower Movement, has over the 9 years been trying to promote. We're promoting a green lifestyle.
Right.
People should do it because they see benefit in it for them.
Mm-hmm.
People should do it not just because it's a national program or a national project. They should do it because they see that a greener Ghana is a healthy environment for me. A greener Ghana is a beautiful place. We sit in this country, we queue at foreign missions wanting to go to greener lands, wanting to go to other places because we feel they are more beautiful.
Right.
We put our own country down because we look around and we say things don't look nice here. The people in those countries worked towards making the environment nice.
Yeah.
We should also take pride in making our environment nice. So one, we should see it as our own individual responsibility.
Right.
Two, we should equip people with the skills for doing so. That is why we do the show. At the show, we bring plants. We have almost 150 exhibitors who have different plants and gardening tools and all that.
Right.
We have conferences. This year, the conference is on greening for youth and women.
Right.
So at the conference, we teach people how to plant and maintain plants.
Okay.
We have workshops. Throughout the year, we have master classes. In next, we just had one. We're having one in the next quarter with Araba Swanika and all that. And then we also have to let people develop the behaviors, associated behaviors, love for plants. Because we are so blessed and we have plants all around us.
We do.
We take them
for granted. We do.
You know?
We do.
And to my fellow Christians, God created plants that are pleasing to the eye and for food. It's written about in Genesis. God actually created the world of a garden. And inside that garden, he created the Garden of Eden.
Mm.
And there must be something about gardens that are good for us.
Right.
And even Jesus the Christ, before he left this earth, went to the Garden of Gethsemane. So if we truly are worshiping God, our worship should also be seen through the preservation of our environment. So yes, Government has said it, but we each have a responsibility.
After all, the Bible says that cleanliness is next to godliness.
So
yes, that's all about
we
it.
We have a responsibility.
Yeah, yeah.
And the Ghana Garden and Flower Movement
right. Is
here to facilitate this lifestyle
right. That
we think people... And I'm so delighted to see that there are a lot more... people selling plants.
Yeah.
It has
I was just going to talk about the pop-up shop that you had. I mean, people bringing tools and all the things that you need for greenery and flowers and all. How did that go?
It went very well.
Yeah, was it the first of its kind?
The pop-up was the first of its kind
okay. Because
guess what? People are asking us. They say one show a year is not enough
not
for
enough.
Us.
Yeah.
And last year we did virtual and people say we want plants. We want to come and learn.
Mm.
And so we're doing the pop-up shows every quarter.
Oh,
there'll be
so
another
it's come
one.
To stay.
It's come to
okay.
stay. And
okay.
gradually, we're praying and hoping we can go to other regions.
Right.
And last year, we began an initiative of connecting Africa through flowers.
Right.
So we are stretching out our arms and hoping to work with other African countries.
Connecting Africa to
Africa is,
through
yes,
flowers.
Africa is beautiful, Africa is rich, and we want to showcase
it to
the world what we have.
It is. Esther Koba, the speaking everything flowers, speaking, connecting to Africa through flowers, and then the benefits of greening our environments and growing flowers as well. Now, it's the 9th edition of the Ghana Garden and Flower Show. She's going to be talking about all the activities marking this year's anniversary. I know it's sometime next week.
It's next week. It's 25th August.
Okay.
25th August.
She has Christmas on her
mind. I know. And I'm a December born.
Oh,
so,
you are.
Yeah.
Wow.
So it's 25th August.
Okay.
Wednesday, 25th August. The exhibitors will be up from morning.
Okay.
But we'll have the opening ceremony in the evening. The Her Excellency, the Rwandan Ambassador, High Commissioner has accepted to be the special guest of honor.
Mm.
We've had a lot of amazing support from foreign missions who think that this is a beautiful country. They're always there in their numbers.
Wow.
And after that, we will have the exhibitions run from 9 a.m. till late every day.
So it's over a period of how long? 3 days, 1 week?
1 week, from 25th August to 29th August.
Okay.
And we have a music night, we have a karaoke night, we have a party in the park, we have, on Saturday evening, we have Nurture to Bloom with the theme Sowing Seeds. It's about how women nurture the same way we nurture plants. And this time we're talking about men nurturing women. Women nurturing men. At home, at work, in politics, wherever.
Oh.
And so we invite her. It will be moderated by an amazing woman, Isise.
And that's
Dr.
in the night,
Isise,
Saturday night.
Saturday evening at
wow.
5 p.m. Then we have the Israeli Green Innovation Award.
Hmm.
3 years ago, the Israeli embassy in Ghana saw a lot of value in what we're doing, and they instituted an award for young Ghanaians who have green enterprises.
Mm.
When they win, they have an all-expense paid trip to Israel to meet other startups in similar enterprises.
Right.
And this has also been amazing. That one is on Sunday.
Right.
And then we'll have the Flower and Garden Awards and we'll end with a closing ceremony. Yes, we are really grateful to various organizations.
I was just
that
about to say that. Who do you have to say
thank you? I brought my Stanbic cup.
You told me earlier.
I brought my Stanbic cup. Stanbic will call us in January and say, Stratcom Africa,
ready.
We're ready. We're ready to support you. Interplast, they have pledged that for as long as we do this, they will always support us. Republic Bank has also always been there. G&J generators, they put their generator there so that if electricity goes off whilst we can have power. We have TV3, I'm here.
Of course.
And all our media partners,
right.
Metro TV, they say for life, they are with us. So
Thank you, Esther.
Lot of Insight, Herald, Dispatch, EIB Group, Asasi Radio, Metro TV, Pan-African TV, Xylophone Media, Unique FM, Omni Media Group, and all the Metropolitan Assemblies.
Okay.
AMA, Ayawaso,
that's a long list.
All of them. I have to congratulate them because there's not a lot of people who see the value in what we are doing.
But they have seen the value in what you do.
Thank you so much
for
having us here this morning.
Thank you so much for coming. Esther Koba, she is the CEO of Strategic Communication Africa. We all say Stratcom Africa. That's a short form of it. And she's here, or she's been here, talking about the 9th Ghana Garden and Flower Show, starting off on the 25th of August. That's next week. Make sure to be a part of it.